This is a short demo of the Meta Segment Anything 2.0 model that has been integrated into the Labelbox image editor as part of the auto segment functionality. If you have used the auto segment functionality in the image editor so far, you're aware that it helps you draw segmentation masks a lot faster and a lot easier. However, if you haven't used it before, this video will serve as a nice introduction to that, which is now powered by the latest Segment Anything 2.0 model, all available without any changes on your end in the image editor. So let me give you a quick rundown of how that works. Here I have the image editor with an image loaded and a couple of masks in the ontology. If I were to choose the mask over there, I will see that it is extracting embedding for the asset. That is sort of the first step where the Segment Anything model behind the scenes is computing an understanding of this image before it can do a lot of segmentation masks without further processing. And as you saw, that took a couple of seconds, but not too long. And when that is done, a snack bar appeared on the right saying it's done. And now you can proceed with it and draw as many segmentation masks as you would like without much latency. So the first option that's available to you is to use the auto segment box function, which is fairly straightforward. You're presented with a crosshair, and you can draw a box around any object here that you would like to segment. So for example, if I would like to segment this leaf right here, I'm going to draw a box around it, and the Segment Anything 2.0 model gets that very accurate. I can also proceed and do that for other things, even things that are diagonal like that. And it gets that fairly well. As you might have noticed, my rectangle actually overlapped with this particular diagonal dotted sort of French fry too, but it didn't get that, right? Which was intentional. I did not want it to get that because my box was around this first one, not the second one completely. So it's very intuitive and smart in that sense. It figures out what you're really trying to point the attention of the model to, and it draws that mask for you and nothing more than that. Now, of course, it will make mistakes sometimes, and it depends on the complexity of the image, and a little bit of trial and error really gets you across the finish line to get the type of masks that you want. Okay, let's use the other, and let's use another mask now to do something very similar, and I'm going to go around some of these dots over here. Fairly straightforward to simply go around and, you know, draw these squares to get the mask that you would like. There's another feature in the auto segment functionality in the image editor where instead of drawing a box, you can simply hover your mouse around various parts of the image, and when you're satisfied with a particular mask, you can just click to create that mask. So let me demo that for you. When I click on this hover and click option, as I move my mouse across various parts of the image, things light up. And the parts that light up are actually what the model thinks you wanted to label, if you were to then proceed with a click. I have not clicked on anything yet, I'm just hovering, but it's sort of doing the work for you before you click on it. Why? Because it wants to give you a sense of what it will label for you, what it will draw a mask around, if you were to henceforth click on that. Now, this is really useful because it allows you to quickly move your mouse over your objects of interest to see if it works, you know, if it can label those things for you. If it can, then why not use this feature? So before you commit to the feature, you can sort of just get a brief preview of what's to come. So let's say I want to label all of these sort of pebbles, right? And it looks like it's going to do a fairly good job over there when I just hover. So I'm going to proceed with that. I'm going to click on that. That's a green dot that indicates to the model that I really care about this, that I want to label this. I'm going to go over here, put another green dot. Okay, so that works, and so on and so forth. I can do the same thing. I can also label them as two separate objects, of course. So there's one sort of green dot here, and that's one mask, and that's another mask. So two different masks. This was an example of two of them sort of clubbed together because it's the same one. Here they're two different ones, and they reflect accordingly over here on the left side objects panel. Now, of course, this can make mistakes. And let's try to create such a mistake at the moment so I can demonstrate to you what the red dot functionality does for us. So let's say we, let's say we do this, right? Okay, so I wanted to label this leaf. I did not want to label these other leaves, but you know, there's a mistake by the model. It's doing a whole bunch of labeling on this side too. I don't want that. So what I can do in that case is I can go on over here to the erase option. I can select the erase option. And what that does is that it will put a red dot. Now, if I were to do a left click on parts of the image or the parts of this mask that I do not want, it will do a red dot. And that is a negative signal to the model. So I don't want this part, as I mentioned. I'm going to go over here and put a red dot. Left click on that. Oh, and that actually kind of messed things up more, but I'm going to go over here and put a red dot there too. Okay, so it seems like it did not get that anymore. It did not get this anymore, but it's kind of messed with the actual leaf that I wanted to get. So I'm going to go over to the positive one again, green dots. I'm going to put a green dot nice and center in the middle. Oh, there you go. Okay, so it got the leaf that I wanted and it removed the parts that I didn't care about. And when I now press the escape key, I have a mask. I have the mask that I really wanted, and then I have those dots at my disposal if I would like to modify them. So red dots again are negative signal to the model to indicate portions of that mask that you do not want the mask to capture, and green dots are signals to the positive signals to the model to indicate to the model that you would like it to capture that portion of the mask or that portion of the image. And that's really it. It's fairly straightforward. This functionality is available as long as you have a mask in your ontology. And the way you get started with it is really just to press the mask feature in a mask tool in your left side panel and just wait a couple of seconds or sometimes even lesser than that for the auto segment functionality to be available. And then you can very easily use either the box option or the hover and click option. And that's pretty much it. We strongly believe that with the new Meta Segment Anything 2.0 model behind the scenes, your mask drawing endeavors will be much faster and much accurate because the new release by Meta, which is seamlessly integrated behind the scenes in Labelbox now, is actually much, much better. It's faster, it's more powerful, it has been trained on a lot more data, and it can generalize to complex images a lot better than before. So we're excited for you to be able to try it out and would love to hear any feedback. Thank you.